Hey, hello everyone. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to construct a use case diagram for airline reservation system. So let's get started. So I have here star UML, and after opening it, you need to go to model and go to add diagram. Here we'll be having a list of diagrams. You need to select the use case diagram. So once you click it, you'll be having the necessary shapes to create it. So here we are going to have two actors. Okay. The first actor is going to be the passenger or the customer who is going to book the tickets in the system. And other actor is going to be the behind the scenes person who is just going to be a representative from the particular airlines, or you can call him a system admin. Okay, so first actor, just place him over here. It's going to be our customer. Okay, and another actor is going to be the system admin or the representative from that particular airlines. Anything you can name it, system admin. Okay, so that's fine. So let's begin with the use cases. So as you can guess, for any online system, we are going to start with the register. Okay, so register in case of any new users coming to our website or portal, they're going to register first. And this next one is going to be login. Okay, so this register is going to be exclusive for the customer only. Login is going to be common because I think the admin is going to, who's the person who will control all the process. So the admin is going to be pre-registered and the customer is a new person, so he's going to log in and register. So you need to have like this use cases exclusive for the customer, exclusive for the admin, and common for both the customer and admin. So it gives a good representation of your diagram. So after the two use cases, next one is going to be the next thing, flight occupancy. Okay, or flight occupancy or availability of the flight. Okay, I don't want to just keep adding more use cases. Availability or occupancy, okay, of the flight. Okay, one of the space, the space is in okay, you don't need to add slash. Okay, availability and occupancy of flight, it's too big. Okay, so you can just cut short into availability or occupancy of flight. So, or you can just keep two use cases. Okay, and next one is view or select the seat. Okay, view or select the seats. Okay, so this is also a use case exclusive for the customer. And next one is going to be the booking history. Okay, booking history, so this one is also going to be exclusive for the customer. You can just see the previous travel history or previous tickets booked in our site. And next one is going to be make payment. So some of them may like to have another actor, okay, like a banking system backend like that. You can also have a banking backend for payment, but I don't recommend that. It's just a common thing, make payment. You can just restrict to make payment itself. And next one is going to be cancel ticket. Okay, cancel ticket. Yeah, so these are kind of like exclusive for the customer itself. And so if you want like something exclusive for the system admin, you can have another one also is there, flight timings. Okay, you can also add flight timings, flight timings and location. There are like so many things you can add for the customer. Okay, so you can keep on adding for the customer, but for there are like very less for, I will just move on everything. Okay, there are like very less thing, less use cases for system admin, so I will try to increase it to the maximum extent. Okay, so first one is going to be the notifications. Okay, notification. So in case of any offer, in case of any delay in flight or quick arrival of flight, you can just give the like notification system, and you can just put a mail or SMS to the customer. So it's going to be notification. And next one is going to be refund. Okay, refund. So in case of any cancellation of ticket or flight cancellation due to some bad weather, you can just refund the admin's the job of the admin to refund the money to the customer. And next one is going to be update schedule. Okay, update flight schedule. That's a really important thing because it's an, so then only the customer can like go and check in the website the whenever on what dates the flight are available and what location, which countries is going to go. So that's a really important job of the system admin. And another one is going to be the statistics. So this statistics, okay, this statistics will include the entire what's the details of the customer, how many customers have ordered, how many people are traveling in flight per day, total profit and loss, total net gain that are getting, total price they have, that the company has gained through the ticket booked by the customer. So it's like going to contain all the bit of information as in the form of stats, like graphs, something somewhat. So that information is also like only private information for the particular airline. You can't leave it that public. That is also handled by the system admin. So I think we have just covered most of the things. Okay, so in case like you can, if you want to add one more use case, you can go for flight status. Okay, flight status. So this one is going to be whether the flight is going to arrive at the right time. Sometimes it can cause like 1 hour or 30 minutes delay. So the customer needs to be notified of that also. So now let's just go with the arrows. Okay, so for customer, we have register and we have like login and we have flight timings, location. And this one also. And you can also like update schedule and seat, okay, seats to that. Yeah, because that's also important thing that needs to be updated time to time. Okay, it can't be static. So view seats for the customer, and customer is also going to see the booking history and the flight status and make payment, cancel the ticket. And then comes our use cases for system admin. System admin login, okay. And the system admin can also send the flight status because he's going to inform the, notify the customer about how long he's going to, the flight is going to come, okay, to the airport. So he has also access to that. And notifications, as I told you earlier. And refund. You can also put from refund to customer also, I think. And update schedule and seats. And finally, the statistics of the flight system. So I think it's, we have done so many use cases. I think it's more than enough. So we have something exclusive for the customer. We have more for customer. Whatever may be the online system, customers at the end is going to have more use cases. We can't avoid that. But we need to at least try to get some unique use cases for our system admin, as we have like notifications, refund, update, statistics, and common one, login is going to be common for all. And flight status is also common. So I hope you have liked this use case diagram for online airline reservation system. I've also done many other use cases for library management system, hospital system, railway reservation system. So it'll be really great if you check those videos also. And mine is actually a programming channel. I've done tutorials in C, C++, Python, Java, Blender, and Blender that is 3D animation and Unity. So it'll be really great if you could check my other videos and subscribe and support me. And thanks for watching.